What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. For those of you who are new around here, my name is Michael, aka Dr. Cellini, and I'm a fifth year interventional radiology resident physician. On today's video, we are going to be talking about the much anticipated mouse that you've seen me talk about on prior videos. So many people have asked me to do a full review on this mouse and why I love it. So that is exactly what I'm going to do today. So let's go ahead and get into it. This video is sponsored by Board Vitals. Now you may remember on my previous videos that I am a huge fan of Board Vitals because they've helped me in more ways than one, including having the most exceptional radiology tubing for the American Board of Radiology core exam. It literally is exactly like the examination and I can't recommend it enough. And that radiology question bank is not the only thing exciting coming out of Board Vitals. Their step one question bank is just as good. These questions are all written and reviewed by top specialists who have taken the exam and have experience writing questions. Question content is mapped out closely to follow the USMLE step one content outline. With more than 2,750 exams on the USMLE step one Board Vitals QBank, you'll get plenty of practice time before actually sitting for the exam. Also, you can now study for free on the go by downloading their new Board Vitals app, available for free on Apple Store and Google Play. And use my code Dr. Cellini to get 20% off anything on their website, including the USMLE Step 1 Board Vitals question bank. All the links will be in the description below. Now, let's get back to the video. Get into the much anticipated mouse review. So I'll first tell you about why I even used this mouse to begin with, or how I came about finding a gaming mouse. So we had a guest grand round speaker come in and talk to us about all of the newest and latest greatest technology and how it helps radiologists become more efficiently in their day-to-day practice. And one of the biggest takeaways I took from his lecture is that he uses a gaming mouse to do all these shortcuts while he's reading behind the PAC station, and it made his life so much more efficient than I could have ever dreamed of. And then I kind of forgot about it. And then one day when I was on night shifts on my diagnostic call session, I sat down at a station and somebody had a Logitech gaming mouse, which was similar to this one. And I sat down, it has buttons on the sides, and I sat down and started using it. First of all, I love the ergonomics. And then I also realized that the buttons on the side can be programmed, and it was making my life so much more efficient that I started doing research that night with my co-resident, and both of us ended up buying a gaming mouse that night. So both of us ended up going with the UTech Smart Venus fully programmable gaming mouse. One of the fellows in my department actually had this mouse and I tried it out and I liked it far better than the Logitech mouse, so I went with this one. So I'll tell you why I chose this one, but first let me talk about all of the things that I love about this mouse, and we'll try to break it down by section here. We'll start with the design, we'll go into the specifications, then we'll talk about why I love it for radiology, all of the cool features it has, the price of the mouse, who is the mouse good for, and the downsides of the mouse. So first, let's get into the design. So first and foremost, the mouse has a nice weight to it. It has a nice rest for the pointer finger or second finger and the third finger as well, and as well as the ring finger on the side. It also has this nice resting plate on the thumb that makes it easy to kind of scroll and hit the buttons on the side. It's also weighted for stability, and you can kind of change these weights as you see fit. The scroll wheel is nice and smooth. There's no lag behind it. It doesn't have one of those resistance-free wheels that kind of just fast scrolls and keeps going until you stop it. The reason I don't like that is because I like the tactile click. It's a very subtle click, but I need that while I'm scrolling through a lot of images. If you get caught up in the free scrolling, sometimes you can just fly through a CT or MRI and you may miss stuff. Also, the ease of getting to the buttons is pretty nice. I have pretty big hands and it doesn't take much of a reach or a movement to get to these buttons. It fits nicely in the hand as well. So let's first discuss the elephant in the room. Why in 2020 did I go with a wired mouse when there are so many wireless options? The answer to that is I cannot have any lag while looking at images. 2 years ago, I brought a wireless mouse into the reading room and plugged it in. And as I was scrolling through images, it was laggy. Sometimes it would skip certain images. And I literally took it out and threw it on the ground. I'd never use it again. And I can't sometimes, and a lot of the newer wireless mouses aren't as laggy, but something as serious as reading someone's image, you literally cannot have one little skip of lag anywhere. So I went with the wired mouse because I don't want to worry about lag whatsoever because it could be detrimental while reading an image on a patient. So you'll notice a lot of gamers also choose wired mouses as well. It's kind of the same thing. I mean, it's not really that serious if they get shot or something while playing a multiplayer game, but it's along the same lines. All right, next let's get into the specifications of the mouse. So for starters, it is compatible with Windows 10, 8, 7, Vista, and Windows XP. There are 5 savable memory profiles, which means I can plug this up and switch the profiles. So 5 different users can use this mouse and have different settings that are customized to them. So if 5 radiologists were using this same mouse, everybody has different kind of settings. And they could sit down, switch to their profile, and everything would be stored in this mouse. There are 19 programmable buttons. We have 12 on the side. We have 4 of the DPI buttons up top. 1, 2 left and right click buttons, and also a button right here as well. This mouse has 16,400 DPI laser sensor, and I had to look that up because I have no idea what the heck that means besides it's very sensitive. So these buttons on the top actually adjust the settings of your DPI from low to very high. So DPI stands for dots per inch. It's basically how many pixels the mouse pointer will move when your mouse moves 1 inch. So for instance, 1600 DPI means that for every inch your mouse moves, your mouse pointer moves 1600 pixels. This mouse goes up to 16,400, which means every inch your pointer flies across the screen and moves 16,400 dots per inch, or pixels. So we have pretty large monitors at work, so I actually adjust this. Each computer is kind of set up differently, so every time I move to a different computer, I can kind of adjust my DPI on the fly. That way I can kind of customize how fast I want to move across the screen. And this also matters a lot when you're measuring small things. So if I'm reading a CT scan and trying to measure a 6 millimeter lymph node, I don't want to have my DPI too high because it's going to be really hard for me to measure something really small because my pointer is going to want to fly across the screen rather than make a very subtle movement and measure. So I like being able to adjust on the fly like that. This mouse also features weight and balance tuning. It has 8 5-gram weights to personalize your weight and center of balance to kind of customize it to your feel. I like it pretty heavy, feels nice on the hand, and I can just make subtle movements and they are very precise. It also has these smooth Teflon foot pads that help you kind of glide across the surface effortlessly without too much friction. Furthermore, it has a braided 6-foot cord with a gold-plated USB plug. So this is actually pretty nice, pretty sturdy as well. So now let's talk about why I love it for radiology. So like I said before, all of these buttons are completely customizable. You can literally program them to do anything. And I'll show you what I have mine programmed to. So for instance, the 1 is programmed to the number 1, which changes to soft tissue window on CT. The number 2 button is the lung window. Number 3 button is the bone window, because 3 looks like a B. That's how I remember it. That's how it's been for 5 years now. 4 is the liver window. And I don't have anything programmed for 5 or 6. So sometimes my hand actually gets a little lazy and I slip down the mouse while I'm dictating. So I actually programmed the number 10 button as the number 1, so it's soft tissue. The number 11 button is also the lung window, just like number 2. And number 3 is the bone window, or number 12. So depending on which ridge my thumb is on is how I determine which button I'm pressing. Up top, I just have the DPI buttons programmed to the how fast the mouse moves. Some people program these to bring up Google Chrome or a search engine. I program this top third button as the zoom button, and that's pretty much all I have. And that does seem pretty basic, but I'm telling you, there's nothing more efficient than scrolling through an image and being able to change windows as you go. So before using this mouse, I used to have to hit the numeric keys on my keyboard to change the windows. So I would have my dictaphone in my left hand, and every time I wanted to change a window to say lung window, instead of pressing 2 on the side button, I would have to put my dictaphone down, hit the number 2 button, pick it up again, start dictating, put the dictaphone down, go back to soft tissue window, hitting number 1, start dictating again, and you can see how that is so inefficient. So once I got a hold of this guy, it kind of changed my life. So my favorite feature of this mouse, besides how efficient it can be and besides how much you can program it to literally do any function you want, is the color scheme on it. So it's actually backlit with LED lights, which you can customize to over 16 million RGB colors. I have this kind of pink and purple blue tone to it. I used to change it depending on my mood. If I was really tired, I would put it all red. I don't know. So now let's talk about the price. It looks pretty expensive. This must be a seriously expensive mouse for how much it does. But actually, it's only $32.99 on Amazon, which is why I pulled the trigger the night after looking into it. I mean, you don't really have much to lose, but this was worth every penny in my opinion. And by the way, I am not sponsored by this company. I just really love this product. I feel like I should share it with you all because it can make your life so much easier if you use this mouse and use it appropriately while reading studies in radiology. So all in all, for everything this mouse is capable of, $32.99 really isn't that bad. So now let's talk about the downsides or the negatives of this mouse. And honestly, the only one I could find is that it's not compatible with Mac or Apple products. It sort of is, but the driver that comes with the mouse in the box can only be loaded on PCs. So luckily all my computers at work are run by PC, so I can load the driver on there and, you know, change the colors and adjust all the settings on there. So the downside is I only have a MacBook at home, which means when I plug it into my laptop, it does have all the colors and saves the settings, but I can't change the settings on my home computer. So it's not that big of a deal because I probably won't change the settings now that I have customized it to my liking, but if you don't have a PC to plug it into, it's probably not that good. All right, so that concludes this video. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I hope you all liked my review on this mouse. Let me know in the comments below if you are going to get this mouse. I will also leave a link to this mouse in the description below so you guys can go get it if you want it. As always, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button and follow me on Instagram if you don't already. Turn on those post notifications so you are notified when I post a new video, which is usually about once or twice every week. Leave a comment below. If I like it, I'll respond to it. Otherwise, I'll see you all on the next video.